Good morning, everyone. You know, one of my many life's mottos is showing up and showing out, and I'm really glad to see you all doing just that this morning. It is wonderful to see everyone today for this event. I do want to take a moment to really enjoy the atmosphere. I'd gotten goosebumps just a few minutes ago, and I'm not joking. I mean, these are great events. This is an excellent opportunity that we have to gather together. I think one of the best ways to acknowledge that is to make a little noise here at home. So first off, let's hear it for the seniors. You're almost there. Now let's hear it for our first years and our transfer students. That was amazing. Again, showing up and showing out. Hi, again, my name is Dr. Peter Testori. I'm Dean of Academic Resources, Title IX Coordinator, and Assistant Professor of Higher Education. And it is truly my privilege to welcome you all to Convocation 2023. Convocation celebrates the beginning of the academic year on college campuses all over the country. We gather together, students, faculty, staff, and members of the administration to mark the beginning of another year in the Academy and to formally induct our newest students into it. Seniors, today you are wearing one piece of your regalia, the mortarboard. At commencement, you will add robes and hoods and tassels, signifying the achievement of your baccalaureate degree. We hope that this early display of your accomplishment serves to spur you and your classmates on to the big final event of the academic year, commencement. Today, we ask you to play an important role in our Bay Path community as you help us welcome our newest students. To our newest students, you're holding maroon caps that you'll be asked to put on later in the ceremony. These caps are a symbol of your induction into the Academy and into the Bay Path community. It is a community united by a shared commitment to the core values of equity, innovation, inclusion, and belonging, collaboration, respect, compassion, and health and well-being. We welcome you into that community with the knowledge that each of you will bring something unique to it. As you may know, our campus theme this year is breakthrough. To me, breakthrough can mean a few things. It can mean an entirely new discovery, or it can mean a triumph over a long struggle, or both. It can take place on a grand societal scale, or a smaller, more personal scale, or both. What matters is the willingness to get there. In your programs, we have featured an excellent quote from the pioneering aviator Amelia Earhart, which I hope you all read and take with you. But I also wanted to share another personal favorite quote of mine from Shirley Chisholm, the first Black woman elected to the United States Congress in 1968. You don't make progress standing on the sidelines, whimpering and complaining. You make progress by implementing ideas. I hope this quote resonates with you in the same way that it does for me. Any progress, any breakthrough, comes from action, from taking your ideas and ideals and putting them into practice. This is not to say, of course, that every idea or every course of action will be perfect or fruitful, but in order to succeed, you must first attempt. Today, during the donning of the cap ceremony, as the faculty surround you and you repeat the affirmation and the response, I hope you look around and take note of everyone that is now part of your community. Everyone here who is supporting you in all your attempts and rooting for you to succeed. Today, you will also hear from someone who was in your place not too long ago. Our speaker, attorney Delmarina Lopez, an alum from 2017, and she'll share her own personal journey at Bay Path and beyond. But first, it is my pleasure to introduce Miranda Dalzovo, President of the Alumni Association Council, to offer her own words and to welcome you. Miranda.
Good morning and welcome, seniors, first years, and transfers. This is a great honor for me to be here today on behalf of the Alumni Association Council. BayPath opens each academic year with two important traditions, first with Campus Awakening and now Convocation. These are traditions of community. From the first moment you became a scholar here at BayPath, you became a member of its community, our community, and it is a membership without expiration. Today, seniors, you extend yourselves to first years and transfers in a commitment to leadership and partnership. It is a commitment that together we are all connected on this journey of lifelong learning. It is that connection that continues to bring me back to BayPath long after I cross the stage, degree in hand. Just as seniors are partners for first years and transfers, so too are alumni partners for all students. We share our experiences, not only those of shared learning at BayPath, but as members and leaders in our chosen fields, because we want you to be successful with us. And we listen to you, seeking to understand your hopes and your challenges, because we want you to be successful with us. Each time I come on campus, I learn something new. I meet amazing students, future leaders. Sometimes it's as silly and fun as Munchie Mania, although I deny all rumors of me dancing while serving food. At commencement, we share in the excitement and help with regalia prep, which was actually my first volunteer event after graduating from BayPath. I have also been a mentor, supporting and empowering through one-on-one connections. Today, I have the honor of standing before you as a volunteer leader in the BayPath community, as president of the Alumni Association Council. I choose to stay connected to BayPath because through this community, I am stronger. And as a community, I want us all to be successful. So today, I extend a hand on behalf of all alumni in welcoming you to this academic year, in commitment to leadership and partnership, and in joy of membership in this BayPath community. Thank you and welcome.
Again, welcome everyone. A quick reminder about Campus Day following this event. It will be taking place inside in Blake. And also, if I could just ask you for one more round of applause right now, thanking Jody Baker, who makes this event possible. And now, without further ado, I will ask you to please rise as the faculty and guests process in. Thank you. Welcome. Everyone can please be seated. At this time, I'd like to invite Carrie Burr, class of 86 and chair of the BayPath Board of Trustees, to the podium to provide her remarks.
Thank you, Peter. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
All right. It also said with smiles. I love it. I love it. Listen, it's so wonderful to be gathered together today, this morning. I have to say, this celebration is like the icing on a cake. You've experienced the annual campus awakening. You are overcoming your first day jitters. And all of us are preparing for a successful academic year. Those of you living on campus may still be putting final touches on your dorm decor. Those of you who commute may be finalizing your routes to school, considering where to travel when traffic is a bear. And faculty may be putting their final touches on their syllabus while learning the names and classroom personalities of your learners. The university's board is working with the president to ensure the needs of our learners are being met while upholding our mission to provide you with the skills and knowledge needed to be successful in your life and career. Whatever your final work is to settle into the new semester, we are all settling together. My message to you this morning highlights our commonality. On August 30th, I had the honor of attending Ally's graduation program. If you're not familiar with Ally, it's the Academic Learners and Leaders Initiative. It's our summer bridge program where a select number of first-year students are invited for the month of August to live on campus and sharpen their math and writing skills. At the end of the program, students submit an essay with this year's theme being about their core values. At graduation, students shared an excerpt from their essay. And the core values presented included beauty, loyalty, security, kindness, knowledge, compassion, love, dedication, friendship, and education. And as I reflected on these values, it dawned on me that this list reflects BayPath University's core values. The university's core values are learners come first, education and knowledge. Diversity makes us stronger, beauty, kindness, security. We are committed to equity, love, friendship, compassion. We pledge to foster inclusion and belonging, loyalty, love, compassion, kindness. We work best as a community that collaborates, education, knowledge, dedication. Health and well-being matter. Compassion, love, friendship, and kindness. In whatever matter, you might cross-reference the Ally list of core values to BayPaths. One thing is clear. We are all a community of shared common values. These values are the ones that your faculty call upon to inspire their work and the board uses as a compass for ensuring the continued success of this institution. Enjoy this community, for we are as alike as we are different. And with beauty, love, security, kindness, knowledge, compassion, dedication, friendship, and education, we will thrive. Carpe diem.
Thank you, Chair Burr. And now, please join me in welcoming the president of BayPath University, Sandra J. Doran.
Good morning. This morning, I'd like to welcome our faculty, our staff, BayPath University trustees. You heard from Carrie Burr, our chair, Wayne Webster, our vice chair, and most importantly, welcome to you, our students. I'd like to begin with a note of gratitude. Please join me in thanking Dr. Testori and Jody Baker and their teams, and all the teams who came together to make today's opening convocation look seamless. So thank you. To our seniors, one word, community. Community is sometimes defined as a group of people who agree to grow together. And you all certainly have grown together. I can assure you this year will go by very quickly. You are on the doorstep to a new life of possibilities and incredible change. It will be an exciting time, but don't rush it. Try to enjoy every moment, because today only comes one time. You will join a very long, very proud group of alumni when you walk across the stage in May. And you're going to meet one of our incredible alumni shortly, and you already met the president and a trustee of our Alumni Association. You have embraced the spirit of this university. Be bold, be daring, and don't ever forget that that's part of who you are. To our first year and transfer students, I urge you to take advantage of all the opportunities that BayPath has to offer. Learn as much as you can, make as many connections as possible. Learn and build your networking skills. I assure you, our alums and our community members will be thrilled to join you on your educational journey. In fact, they will be honored to participate. And participate in everything, whether it's athletics, whether it's research, whether it's clubs, whether it's forming a new club, whether it's becoming a peer mentor or a tutor. Get out of your comfort zone, because this is one time in your life, and there will be others, but this is an easier time, when it's just a little bit easier to try new things. Go to events, as well as your classes. Don't forget to go to your classes. Talk to your classmates in Blake Dining Commons, the fitness center, while hanging out in the fireplace lounge. Broaden your horizons in every way possible. This is a really important notion I want to leave you with. Be curious about everything. Everything. There is no question that is too small to be answered. There is no question that is too minor to be explored. Take advantage of where you are at this university to say, I'm just going to ask every question, because that's how we learn. I want to switch to our convocation speaker. Our convocation speaker epitomizes the carpe diem spirit of our university. At BayPath, she was involved, enthusiastic, and a natural-born leader. And those are not my words. Those are the words of her classmates. She was an important team member for 4 years for the Women's Leadership Conference. And for our first year and transfer students, I urge you to ask as many questions about our Women's Leadership Conference. The date is April 4th. Thank you. So please be sure and find out about that, because it is a phenomenal event. So I would like to introduce you to this phenomenal BayPath woman, Attorney Della Marina Lopez of the class of 2017. Della Marina was raised in Chicopee. She is a first generation college graduate who earned her Bachelor of Science in Criminal Justice and then went on to law school. Della Marina, you know that's a profession and we share in common. We're both lawyers. As a high school student, Della Marina was the youngest person to serve as an intern for the governor's Western Massachusetts office when she was just 16. Think about that. Her interest in government and serving the people continues to this day. Currently, she is a city councilor in Chicopee, where she represents Ward 3, the ward that she grew up in. She is also the founder of Della Marina Lopez Consulting, where she leverages her legal skills to support small to mid-sized businesses. So some days when you think you're busy, think about Della Marina. If you are driving or visiting Chicopee, you will see signs with Della Marina's name on them. She is a candidate for the mayor of Chicopee. She cites her deep-seated commitment to social justice and her dedication to creating a brighter future for the city as her inspiration for running for office. Della Marina describes herself as passionate. She is a passionate advocate and public servant. She is an educator, an attorney, and as you heard, a small business owner. She is on the board of the YWCA of Western Massachusetts. Her work and commitment to community service and equity have earned her several notable awards. She has been recognized on the Latino 30 Under 30 list for El Mundo Boston in 2022. She has been recognized as the Business West 40 Under 40 class of 2023. And just last week, she was recognized to be one of the top 100 Latino leaders in Massachusetts. Please join me in giving Della Marina a warm BayPath welcome.
Good morning. Hola. Good morning. That was not enough energy for me. Hola. Good morning. Greetings to Board Chair Carrie Burr, President Doran, Interim Vice President of Academic Affairs, Dr. John Karen, Dean of Academic Success? Resources, thank you. Dr. Peter Testori, Dr. Peter Testori, and of course, you all, our first year transfer and senior students. Thank you to BayPath University for inviting me to join you all today as this year's convocation speaker. I am a proud alumna of this prestigious organization. This institution is where I made great memories, lifelong friendships, learned a lot both academically and about myself, and took advantage of every opportunity presented to me. In fact, 10 years ago, I sat in the same seats that you are all sitting. And as I listened to that speaker, I vividly remember, I was sitting in the back corner over there, I vividly remember saying to myself one day, I'm going to deliver a convocation speech here at BayPath. And here we are. There is so much power in manifesting the life that you want. And I still continue to take advantage of the many opportunities presented to me, as many as possible. What I didn't realize back then was how much of it would turn into opportunities to also give back. During your time here at BayPath, I urge you, and I didn't plan this with President Doran, but I urge you to take advantage of all the amazing opportunities you will be presented. Join that club that piques your interest. Lead that club. Start a new club. Get involved on campus. Volunteer. Go to events. Even if it doesn't sound like it would be your thing, just go. Go to conferences. Eat in the dining commons. Even if you're a commuter, find community. At BayPath University, as you heard, I served as the president of the Student Government Association. I also served as a council member of the Diversity and Inclusion Community Council, and I was a student representative on that. That was a volunteer position. I also worked as a student assistant for the Department of Strategic Alliances, Events, and Community Engagement. I was deeply involved with the Women's Leadership Conference. Go to the conference. And I was Dr. Leary's presidential ambassador. Through my work in all of those positions, I was exposed to the inner workings of BayPath, of the Women's Conference, and to many people in my community, which have become a part of my larger network. I learned how to move in spaces that I had not had exposure to. My time here and my involvement strengthened my ability to lead and serve simultaneously. To those of you who are first-year students and transfer students, it starts here for you. On this great journey you're about to embark, this is a clean slate for you to learn, for you to grow, and for you to become. You get to choose who you want to be. I had a great example of hard work and dedication growing up in my mother, who is here with me today. Yes. Thank you, Mom. I still have that great example in her as she has navigated through life working hard, taking risks, betting on herself, even when others doubted her. I also have a great model and role model and support system in my older sister who snuck out to go take a meeting call, but was here supporting me as well. You know, during my time at BayPath, I had to grow my own wings despite that foundation. I had to take everything they had taught me growing up and choose my own path. I had to break through. Those of you who are embarking here on your last year at BayPath, I hope you too have found your wings. And I'm sure they're beautiful. Remember to show up authentically wherever you go. Your breakthrough is not about changing who you are. It's about evolving into who you want to be. It's about being intentional about how you show up in spaces, how you show up for spaces, and the impact that you have on any space you enter, no matter how you show up. I show up in curls, hoop earrings, and red bottoms. You show up whatever means you show up that way. No matter what it is that you decide to embark on after your time here, whether it's a new job, another degree, building a family, whatever it is, stand tall in knowing that those spaces need you and what only you can bring to them. I am still breaking through. As a Latina woman, I chose to break through glass ceilings and pull up a chair at tables that were not built for me. I break through by making myself comfortable in spaces that were not created for me or for my people, but where I know I am needed, where my voice is needed. As you heard, I am an attorney and a city councilor, and I'm currently running for mayor in Chicopee, where I grew up. I am the first and only person of color ever elected in my city for municipal office. I'm currently the only Latina, of course, ever elected on a municipal level. And I'm one of less than a dozen women who have ever served on the city council in 2023. You know, many people say that's amazing and they celebrate it, but it also makes you think, who were these spaces created for? And the answer is not for us, but who needs to be in those spaces? We do. Those spaces were not created for people like me, but I belong there. So I work hard. I advocate. I urge you to do the same. Breakthrough is just as much about you as it is about others. Show up for yourself and for others. And that's my parting nugget for you all. In all that you do, lead and serve simultaneously. Manifest the life that you want, work hard for it, and believe in your dreams. Even if they sound out of reach or unimportant to others, believe in yourself. If you can think it, you can do it. If you can think you can be the convocation speaker at BayPath at some point, you can do it. In fact, what you think you will do, again, lead and serve simultaneously. Your breakthrough impacts everyone. Thank you.
My husband always says, what you focus on manifests, so I definitely connected with those words. Thank you so much. And now, please join me in welcoming Interim Vice President of Academic Affairs, Dr. John Caron, to introduce the affirmation and donning of the cap ceremony.
Good morning. Thank you, Del Marina. It is wonderful to have you and your mom back at BayPath. And thank you for sharing your story with us this morning. Let's give her another hand. That was really pretty incredible. Some of you might have woke up this morning and said to someone, what is it? And do I have to go? And we're really glad that you showed up. But simply put, it's a tradition. It's the official kickoff, if you will, of the academic year. And traditions are very important. Because they're one way that helps you form a personal connection and a bond with BayPath University. It is now my great privilege to introduce the donning of the cap ceremony, where we will formally induct our incoming class into the BayPath University community of learners. During this ceremony, your faculty will surround you by standing in the aisles on either side, as you recite the affirmation and response, and don your maroon caps. This is symbolic of the role that your faculty will play in supporting you over the next few years. During the next few minutes, while our amazing director of performing arts and musical activities, Bobby Tomasulo, let's give Bobby a quick hand. As Bobby plays the musical interlude, our faculty will rise and recess to the main floor while our senior delegate, Rohan Mustafa, and our first year representative, Alana Long, join me here at the podium. I am pleased to introduce our senior delegate, Rohan Mustafa, and our first-year representative, Alana Long, who will help lead the induction of our new students. On behalf of the senior class, Rohan will ask her classmates to stand, turn to face the new students, and will lead them in reading aloud the senior affirmation printed in the program. Following the senior affirmation, new students should stand as Alana leads her classmates in reading aloud the response, which is also found in the program.
Good morning, y'all. Oh, there we go. My apologies. I'll ask that you guys stand up and recite the senior affirmation and face the first years and transfers. Welcome to the, y'all are supposed to read with me. Welcome to the Bay Path Learning Community. We invite you to join us to welcome leaders who seek and bring social justice to the 21st century. We are self-motivated problem posers and problem solvers inside and outside the classroom. We are partners in curiosity and hunger for knowledge. We value each other for differences, and we will learn from our experiences in order to live thoughtfully and deliberately. We aim to foster lifelong learning through open dialogue and partnership as we reimagine a future that is inclusive and equitable for all. Thank you. And I'll pass it off to Alana Long.
Hi, everyone. May all the first year and transfer students please stand. Okay. And the little pamphlet, you're gonna recite this with me. We have been welcomed to your call to our new community. We are empowered to become leaders who will bring social justice and change to the 21st century. We will approach the future with openness, creativity, and integrity, and will commit to becoming lifelong learners, both inside and outside the classroom. It begins at Bay Path. It will go on forever.
New students, I now invite you to place your caps on your heads as we all join in welcoming you into the Bay Path University community of empowered learners and leaders. Class members of 2027, you are now a part of something that is much bigger than yourselves. You are now an integral part of the Bay Path community. Wherever you go from this place, you will always be a member of this community, and you will have access to networks and relationships that extend well beyond this place and time. Class of 2024, I hope this is a comforting thought as you consider that for many of you, this is your last year on our campus. We are a community of learners and leaders. We are a diverse community made up of people with vast array of stories and experiences like Del Marina. And we are responsible for each other's success. This is your community. You are Bay Path. Claim this community as your own and make it the best year ever. You may sit now. Thank you for joining us here this morning. I would like to remind the seniors and new students to please gather outside on the lawn after the recessional for your official class photos. Will you now please rise and remain standing during the recessional, beginning with the faculty, followed by our president, speakers, and finally the seniors, and then our first year and transfer students. Have a wonderful academic year. Thank you very much. Heartbreak, pick up all the pieces, don't stop dancing in the bleachers. It's gonna be your turn to play, gonna be your turn to play. Sometimes it's raising your voice, sometimes it's making some noise.
Don't stop. Here comes the break.